Okay, so question one looks at the currents flowing into a junction. Now, Kirchhoff's current law basically looks at the current into a junction must equal the current out of a junction. So, if I was to, this, you've got to look at the sign here. We've got 2.3 amps going in to this junction. We've got 1.2 coming in as well. So, the total current coming in must be the total current coming out. So a number of you will probably sort of think that 1.2 plus something is going to give 2.3. But in actual fact, we've got 3.5, so current in Okay, so current in is 3.5 amps, so the current out must also be 3.5 amps. Okay, question two. In the following circuit, the current through the ammeter A1 is 0.5 amps. Well, let's have a look at what happens with the current. If we have a current coming through this way, this has to be all of the current. This is all of the current. And then what happens is, through a parallel, we're going to have some current, we'll call this I1, going through here, and we're going to have I2 going through here. Now, these don't have to be the same. I1 does not equal I2. The only time when the current through 1 and 2 is going to be the same is when they have the same resistance. Now, with the voltage, though, V1 does equal V2 because it's a parallel arrangement. So, voltage through this parallel circuit is the same for each of these, and the current, though, is not. What is the current through A2? So, first of all, we know what the current... it says here that the resistors are equal value. So, if they're equal value, then we know that the current through 1 is going to be equal to the current through 2. You don't need to know any values. But in this case, because we know that... we've got 0.5 amps. We know that that current's going to split off and we're going to get 0.25 amps for each of those. Current of 1.5 amperes is measured flowing through a different ammeter. How much charge passes through this ammeter in 1.5 minutes? Well, we need to use this relationship. The current is the rate at which... the rate of charge. So if we have 1.5 amps, then that is a given amount of charge over, and 1.5 minutes, we'd have to convert that to seconds, so we've got 90 seconds. So therefore, the charge, and this is obviously in coulombs, so therefore, the charge is equal to 90 times 1.5, which is 135 coulombs. Seems like a lot of coulombs. Okay, the next one. In the following circuit, the ammeter is reading 1.25 amps and the voltmeter is 3.75 volts. What is the magnitude of the resistance of the circuit? Well, we have to use that before, so we've got V equals I times R and total resistance. We can work, use this Ohm's law as well to find the voltage drop across if we had more than one resistor. So we know that the resistor is therefore P divided by I. The voltage is 3.75 volts and the current is 1.25 amps. So the resistance is going to be 3 ohms. What is the voltage supplied by the battery? Well, it appears as though there's no all of that voltage that is supplied by the battery is going directly through that resistor. So it appears as though the voltage supplied by the battery is 3 volts. Quite a simple question, really. Question 6. What single resistor could replace the following 3 resistor combination? So first of all, we can draw this in a equivalent circuit is the equivalent of basically having one resistor in series to a 4 in series with a 4 ohm resistor. Okay, so this side is quite easy to work out. But we need to find an equivalent resistance of this arrangement here. Now, if I go to and scroll through to the end, go through the end and show you. We need to use this here. So for resistance in parallel, we have each resistance the power of negative 1 or 1 over that. So R1 to the power of negative 1 equal to 1 over R1. So I'd like to write it like this, that the equivalent resistance, we had 2 resistors in parallel, 1 and 2. This is 1, this is 2. To find the equivalent resistance of those, we would 1 over 2, 1 over resistance of 1 plus 1 over resistance of 2, which is this R to the negative 1. Back to those R. To the power of -1. And if you put that in your calculator, you can find it out. Now, there's a few things that will help you in doing these calculations, and that's, first of all, if you have resistors in parallel, there is no way you can have a resistance higher than a large resistor. It's always going to be lower. If you have 2 resistors of the same resistance in parallel, they're going to be exactly half of the resistance. So I can tell you automatically, because I've actually, know these principles, is that 2 4 ohm resistors, without even doing any calculations, is going to be 2 ohms. Now, if I had 3 4 ohm resistors, 3 4 ohm resistors, and I could also tell you that it's going to be this 4 divided by 3. Or if we do it long ways, we're going to have 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 to the power of negative 1. Well, 1 over 4 3 times. 3 over 4, the negative 1 just means that we're switching these signs around. So that's going to be 4 over 3. So you can have obviously more than 2. In this case, though, the equivalent resistance of this section is 2 ohms. How can we do it long ways? 1 over 4 plus 1 over 4 to the power of negative 1, which is equal to 2 over 4 to the power of negative 1. Which is equal to 4 over 2, or just 2. So what single resistor could place the following 3 resistor combination? You have a 2 ohm resistor in series with a 2 ohm resistor, so it's going to be 4 ohms. Moving on, question 7-8 refers to the following. Well, we've just done that question, so I'm not sure why that's a repeat. But I'm pretty sure with this one, they're making the assumption that this is just a wire which is has no resistance. So what single resistor could replace this would be simply just a 4 ohm resistor. Because quite clearly electricity is going to take this path, and it's certainly not going to, there might be some electrons going through here, but virtually none. So it'll be a negligible amount, so it's all going to go through here. So 4 ohms. What is the name of the direct path from A to B? Well, I guess you'd short circuit. Path of no resistance. Question 9 and 10. thermistor has the following resistance temperature characteristic. Now, a thermistor, like a few other things, like so we've got a thermistor, we've got a diode, they don't follow the common sort of ohmic voltage relationship. So if we have a current, an ohmic device will follow a straight line, whereas these certainly don't. They can have all relationships such as this. This is looking at temperature and resistance. But so let's have a look at what the question is asking. The thermistor is placed in the following circuit. What current flows through the ammeter when the temperature is 50 degrees Celsius? So in order to do that, we need to look at the graph. And we've done this in a couple of the Year 12 questions as well that we looked at. So in the, on the graph, it looks to me that at 50 degrees, the resistance is 30 ohms. So 30 ohms, this is going to be 30 ohms for the time being. So what current flows, so what happens is as the temperature increases, decreases, the resistance of this thermistor changes, and that increases the or decreases the resistance of this total circuit. Now at this stage, we're going to have a resistance total of 72 ohms, and we have, now what happens is the resistance can change. The voltage supplied by the circuit is always going to be the same, which is 18 volts, and then as the, since the voltage is proportional to the resistance, then the only thing that's really changing is this current. So I is V over R. So as the resistance changes, so does the current. So what current flows through the ammeter when the temperature is 50 degrees? Well, I is equal to V over R. We know our voltage is 18, and our resistance, looking at this diagram, is 30 plus 42, 72. And the current is going to be 0.5 amps. The thermistor is considered to be a non-ohmic device. Explain what is meant by the term non-ohmic in this context. Well, it does not follow Ohm's law. There is not a linear relationship between voltage and current. So if we were to look back up here, we're asking the voltage is proportional to the resistance, and obviously voltage is proportional to the current. Well, it is proportional to the current for this, but it's not a linear relationship. So it's not a steady, if you double the current, you double the voltage, and so on. So when looking at non-ohmic devices, they do not have a linear relationship. Question 11 to 13, a student is studying for her exams in the cold winter months. She uses a 1200 watt single bar radio to keep her warm. So let's write down what we know for starters. P for power is equal to 1200 watts. She studies 3 hours per night, so time is 3 hours per night, 5 days a week. For 4 weeks. So we need to work out the kilowatts of hours of energy she used. So let's have a look at what kilowatt hours is. Okay, so a kilowatt hour is 1st of all, if we look at in terms of energy, energy is power times time. So we've got 216,000 seconds to the power of 4. 25.92. Okay, cool. And we've got by 10 to the power of 7. So this is in joules. Now, a kilowatt hour is a certain amount of joules. It's basically 1 equals to